Let's all close our eyes and pray to Jesus to help us out in this time of need right now. Oh, Lord, we ask you to please give us your strength, give us your hope, and give us your clarity. Please help us. We ask you to please take care of Nell. And in this test, may you please show us an unadulterated sign of whether or not we should continue upon this way. If we should go ahead and indeed find out whether we should continue down the path.
Marcus.
Is this regular water?
Yes.
That's the temperature change. I was afraid of this. We will proceed with the exorcism. I'm afraid that I suspect that Nell is possessed with a demon named...
Abalam?
Abalam.
Hasta. What is this? What kind of language is this?
Do you not read Latin?
No, sir.
It's all right. I got it for you. What this tells us is... Abalam. Inside Abalam, right there. So you can see. Right. Solus, solus, excess. Next, what it says is he's very powerful. He's perhaps the most powerful demon in the entire book. What he does is like a snake. He wraps himself around the coil of the soul of the person. And that is why there's the temperature fluctuation up, down, like Nell was showing. The thing about Abalam is that he preys on the flesh of the innocent. He defiles the flesh of the innocent. That is what he does.
Defile.
And it's particularly bad when he's in young girls. Look at him. It says right here that the possessed only salvation will come in death.
What? The only salvation is death.
Unless she is exorcised.
You're fried!
Hello, Caleb.
You threw something in there. I saw you. But I won't tell, okay?
I don't know what you're talking about.
That is really good. We don't have any problems now.
This'll shake nicely. Come in. Come now. Stand here for a second. Caleb, if you would, over there. Lewis beside him. Nell, go ahead, get on the bed. You can sit, or you can lay down. Whatever makes you comfortable.